Hi everyone, welcome to the third video on Python learning series for network engineers. In this video I'll be doing a comparison between Python version 2 and 3. Although Python 2.7 is used in some places, the adoption to Python 3 is growing quickly. As I have mentioned in the previous video, Python 2 will not be supported after 2020, so I would suggest you to learn Python 3 instead of Python 2. Earlier, one of the major challenges with Python 3 was the older libraries were written in Python 2 and all those libraries needs to be rewritten in Python 3. But now most of the libraries are supported in Python 3 and even the community support is really good. We will check some of the Python community documents for that reference. Now for checking the release schedule and the details of Python, you need to go to the home page, go to download, all releases. Then if you scroll down, you can see the release schedule for 2.7. we'll open that and redirect to the PEP document. PEP stands for Python Enhancement Proposal. Here they will have a lot of all the Python reference documents, so you can go to PEP index. Here we will have all the documents available. So the document which says the release schedule of Python 2.7 is 373. Yeah, release schedule, we'll go to release schedule. So here, yeah, if you can in the update section, you can see the end of life date for Python 2.7 has been moved 5 years into the future 2020. That means I think they have announced end of life for 2015 and then they have extended this to 2020. This decision was made to clarify the status of 2.7 and relieve worries for those users who cannot yet migrate to Python 3. So they have given some time for people who is using 2.7 to migrate to 3. And so you can see they're not guaranteeing any bug fixes after 2020. And here they're saying being the last of 2.x series is 2.7, so 2.7 is the last version which comes in 2.x series, so after that there will be only 3 series. Okay, and now we'll go to the feature comparison and future of 2.7 release. For that we'll go to the documents and docs. We'll go to Python 3.x doc. Here you need to go to what's new documents since 2.0. if you scroll down, you'll be able to see the future of Python 2.x. here you can click on that. So even here they are saying the same thing. So 2.7 is the last major release in the 2.x series, and as the Python maintainers have shifted the focus of their new feature development effort to Python 3.x series, so even they are suggesting to use 3.x going further. And here again they are mentioning PEP 373 doc, which we have referred already. Yeah, that's all. If you're interested, you can read for the more details here. Now we'll go back and see the feature differences between 2.7 and 3. We'll go to what's new in Python 3. That's where it will show exactly what are the changes. The major changes I have noticed are, one is a print syntax difference. They have added additional parentheses there. Other than that, strings have become Unicode by default, so we need to give an ascii encoding in front of string, and even we need to give a define bytes in front of string. So we'll show that ascii and byte. I'll show one of the reference library so that you'll be able to easily understand. I'll go to Python doc. We'll go to library reference. Okay, I'll go to telnet library. Yeah, here we have sample code for telnet. You don't need to worry about the complete code now. I'll be explaining this code in detail in upcoming videos. So I'm just showing the difference between version 2 and 3 with this example. I'll open another tab. I'll go to 2.7. Telnet library. Yeah. We'll do a comparison between these two. Yeah. So you can see the print statement difference here. In the Python 2, there is no additional parenthesis here. You can see here they have added additional decode ascii for print. Even you can see in the TN read password until here, it was just a string here, but you need to define this as a byte. Even while giving the data, you need to give user. Here it was a plain user. While feeding the user username or any other information, here you need to even define the encoding, encode to ascii. And while getting the output, you need to do a decode. In addition to that, another change is in Python 2, the input syntax was raw underscore input, and here the syntax is just input. We can see here user equals input. So we'll check that as well here. Underscore input. Yeah, so here they are saying raw underscore input was renamed to input. Python also has dependencies. So in the next video, I'll show you how to install Python package manager PEP. So see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.